FileZilla Pro Series. In this video, we'll teach you how to keep your authentication tokens safe with FileZilla Pro. In this tutorial, you will learn how to securely store authentication tokens with FileZilla Pro. While we use OneDrive, the instructions work also with Dropbox, Google Drive, and Google Cloud protocols. To learn how to configure connections with other protocols, watch the other tutorials you find in the video description. Launch FileZilla or FileZilla Pro. In order to grant access to data, Google Cloud, Google Drive, Dropbox, and Microsoft OneDrive require an authorization step, which creates an authentication token. Click Connect. This step creates an authentication token that lasts until FileZilla Pro gets closed. Once you quit FileZilla Pro, all authentication tokens are discarded and you'll need to authorize protocols again at the next run. To preserve authorizations between sessions, you need to use a master password. FileZilla Pro now stores authentication tokens. And at the next run, you just need to enter the master password. By selecting this option, FileZilla Pro will prompt you for the master password just once per session. If you don't want to use a stored authentication token, you can instruct FileZilla Pro to forget it. Enter the master password, and you see that FileZilla connected without the authorization step. In this video, you learned how to store the authentication tokens with FileZilla Pro. FileZilla Pro is fast and reliable. Plus, it supports a variety of other cloud protocols: Amazon S3, Microsoft Azure, Google Cloud Storage, Google Drive, Dropbox, Microsoft OneDrive, Amazon EC2, Backblaze B2, and WebDAV. Are your website files ready to go? Time to get your copy of FileZilla Pro. Go to FileZillaPro.com and buy it with confidence. See you at the next video of the FileZilla Pro series.